this year, our flu season is on track to be a pretty typical one. We're seeing about the number of cases and severity and the strain types that we would expect to see. The one unique thing about this season is that we're seeing an increase in cases earlier in the season than we typically do. It's also coinciding with an increase in some other respiratory viruses. So it appears as though there may be a higher level of infection in the community. It's not all necessarily influenza though. So some common sense precautions to prevent transmission of the flu are to stay home from school or work when you're sick. We also recommend that you don't return to work or school until you have been without a fever for 24 hours. And that is no fever without being on medications that reduce fevers such as Tylenol. Some symptoms of the seasonal flu are fever, cough, runny nose, headaches, body aches. Occasionally, you will see gastrointestinal symptoms, nausea, vomiting. This is not very common, however. So the Centers for Disease Control, the CDC, offers some guidance on when to seek emergency medical treatment when you're having flu-like symptoms. So they differ for children and adults. For children, it's good to watch out for a bluish tint in the skin, excessive fussiness to the point of not wanting to be held, signs of dehydration, like no tears when the child is crying. And again, you can find a more complete list of symptoms to watch out for at the CDC. And for adults, we look for things like chest pain, abdominal pain, shortness of breath, confusion, also flu-like symptoms that resolve and then return with fever and a worsening cough. These are all things that the CDC recommends that you seek emergency or consider seeking emergency medical care for. Here at Johns Hopkins Hospital, we take some extra precautions above and beyond what's recommended in the community to protect our patients that are particularly vulnerable, as well as the families. So basically that entails when we start seeing more cases of respiratory virus, then we try to limit visitation of children to the hospital. So for the Children's Center, that means we ask that individuals under the age of 16 do not visit. In our adult towers, we ask that children under the age of 12 do not visit. And some units may also have, some specific units may also have some separate guidelines that pertain specifically to their population. And we also ask that you not visit, we also ask our staff to not come to work if they have a fever and respiratory symptoms. And we ask the same of visitors.